nucleated red blood cells is an immature red blood cells that present in the blood circulation most commonly in cases of severe anemia. So the question here, why the bone marrow release immature red blood cells or nucleated red blood cells to the circulation in severe anemia? As we know, the most important function of the red blood cells is to transport oxygen from the lungs to the tissue. So the presence of anemia will result in reduced the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, which result in hypoxia. The hypoxia stimulates the production of erythropoietin from the kidney. This erythropoietin stimulates the production of red blood cells from the bone marrow. So in cases of severe anemia means there is a severe decrease or there is a marked decrease in the red blood cell count in the blood circulation, which means that the oxygen carrying capacity is reduced, which results in presence of hypoxia, stimulates the release of erythropoietin from the kidney and result in stress on the bone marrow to release more red blood cells. So the bone marrow at first normally produce red blood cells and release them to the circulation, but the red blood cells released from the bone marrow is not sufficient to correct the hypoxia. It's not sufficient to correct the hypoxia, which means a further stimulation from the erythropoietin to the bone marrow to release more red blood cells. So the bone marrow releases immature red blood cells in the form of reticulocytes, which is larger than the red blood cells to the blood circulation. And then at a later stage, if the anemia persists, then the bone marrow release become exhausted and unable to synthesize more red blood cells and release the nucleated red blood cells in the circulation. Nucleated red blood cells in circulation is an immature red blood cells, unable to bind the hemoglobin, unable to perform the function of the red blood cells in the circulation. As we know, it is difficult to detect the nucleated red blood cells when we use the hematology analyzer. So the nucleated red blood cells is detected during the manual differential count or during examination of the blood film. The hematology analyzer counts the red blood cells as a white blood cell. So this will result in increase in the total leukocytic count. So it is very important when the number of nucleated red blood cells detected during manual differential count is greater than 5 cell per 100 white blood cells, it is very important to make correction for the white blood cell count, because the nucleated red blood cells is not lysed by the diluting fluid during white blood cells counting and will be counted as a leukocyte or as a small lymphocyte. So it is very important to correct the count of the white blood cells using equation. This equation as follows: the corrected white blood cell count is equal to the uncorrected white blood cells count multiplied by 100 and divided into the number of the created red blood cells per 100 white blood cells during the differential count and plus 100. So the result will be the corrected white blood cell count. White blood cell count.